Good morning, everyone. So first of all, thank you for the organization to give me this opportunity to present some data from Portugal. As Greg said, I'm Carlos Lopes. I am a professor at the University of Lisbon. I used to teach viticulture since 30 years ago. And when I have some time, I do some research, which is not the case right now because I'm plenty of students. So the idea for this presentation was to talk a little bit about the water competition by cover crops in the vineyards. So the talk, so these computers are losing some information, but doesn't matter. This was the talk outline, so the first paragraphs, which are not there, was to tell you that I'll do a brief introduction, and then I will present some case studies in different regions of Portugal where we did some experiments. So for this brief introduction, everybody knows this stuff, so just to remember that right now vineyard cover cropping is a very important cultural practice that is recommended as an adaptation measure for climate change and for all type of sustainable viticulture. So why is that? Because there are several benefits coming from this cultural practice, like you can read from this list. Some of them are more important. For example, in steep slope vineyards, the prevention of soil erosion is really an important feature. Another thing is the increase in biodiversity, which is also very important for enhance pest management. In climates like we have in Portugal with hot springs, but usually with the soil plenty of water at that time, we have a very strong vegetative growth during spring. And so we can, with cover crops, we can reduce this vegetative growth during spring. So could be a good cultural practice to reduce cost in canopy management, to improve grape composition and health. Another important feature that cover crops can provide is the help in mechanization, mainly when we have dry seasons. For example, this is a chucked harvest machine in a slope vineyard, and I tried to insert here this video, but it doesn't run here in these computers from here. So, but the idea was to show that in this vineyard, this is a treatment with soil tillage, and we had a very wet harvest, and so this is a clay soil, and the tractor was not able to carry the machine, so we have we lost traction with this in this situation, and of course the tractor did a kind of tillage because it cannot run the harvest machine. There are also potential drawbacks. Of course, you can read from the lists. So there are more costs if you seed the cover crops. You have costs with machinery. But the most important drawback in climates like Mediterranean ones is the competition for resources, mainly for water. And this is really a problem if you don't have water for irrigation, because you can have a very strong decrease in vegetative growth. You see this vineyard, this is summertime, so, and the shoots were not able to achieve the top of the trellis. And if we have a very dry year, we can have water stress on those situations. So we have to understand a little bit more about this contribution of cover crops to vineyard evapotranspiration. If you take a look to the literature, you will find several examples of this transpiration, the contribution of the transpiration that could go from 1 millimeter per day to 3 or more millimeters per day, which is almost equivalent of what the vineyard will transpire. There are several factors that can influence this contribution. So the cover crop species is one of the most important factors, because there are species that are more competitive than others. The height and architecture of the cover crop vegetation, the percentage of soil cover, cover crop growth periods, management, and also the vineyard canopy height and interrow space. Look at this shade here. This is a vineyard in Geisenheim, Germany. We did some experiments over here. And this shade will influence also the transpiration of the cover crops, because it will reduce the light interception in the floor. So this will influence also. So the way you training your vines will also have influence. For example, in this case, we have compared several weeds and cover crops, and this in this axis you have the hour of the day, and you can see that it's only at the midday, at noon, where you get higher transpiration rate, because in the morning and in the afternoon you have low transpiration rates, because the cover crops don't get enough light to do this gas exchange. So everyone try to understand a little bit more about cover crops and try to adopt this cultural practice. But as I said before, in our Mediterranean regions, there is the adoption of cover crops is limited by the concern of this competition for water. However, the interaction between cover crops and vines are still poorly understood. And we need to do more experiments to better understand if indeed this competition could be avoided or could be mitigated. And this is the reason that I'm going to present some results of some experiments we did in Portugal in three different regions, using only the data from one season after 3 or 4 years of the cover crop establishment. So I will begin with a region in the north center of Portugal, which is the Down region, the region where Touriga Nacional is most grown, and it's mainly the origin of this variety. This is Touriga Nacional. And so we did an experiment. There is a poster telling more about this experiment. And we compared soil tillage against a sward with resident vegetation. And we also have other treatments, like difference in the row, like use of herbicides or mulch. But I will show you only data comparing soil tillage as the control against the resident vegetation. We use the a capacitance probe. We have some access tubes, and in this case we use the tubes in the interrow to access soil water content. As you can see here in this plot, in And at bud burst, the soil achieved the field capacity. And then throughout the growing season, we have a decrease in soil water content. But as you can see from the green line is the cover crop, you have a difference. So low water content on the cover crop, which is caused, of course, by cover crop transpiration. If we try to evaluate, to quantify this difference by, for example, calculating the daily water use within the main phenological periods, you can see that, for example, for the spring period, bud break to flowering, we have a significantly higher water use on the cover crops. But then, during the flowering variation period, we have the opposite. And during the ripening period, no significant difference. Meaning that when we put all together, we have no significant difference on daily water use between the two treatments. Going a little bit farther in detail, here you can see the volumetric soil water moisture. So the first line on the left is a bud burst, and then on the right is a bud burst, and on your left is the harvest. So you see there is a difference along the season, and if you evaluate this by quantifying the soil water storage variation, you see that in the first layers, you have a higher consumer by the cover crops. So you have higher storage variation in the first layers, in this case, to 0 to 90 centimeters. At deep layers, there is no significant difference. But this is in the period flowering, bud break flowering. When you go to the period flowering variation, you see the opposite. More consumer by the soil tillage than the cover crops. Sorry. But if you analyze the fraction of this water that is coming from deeper layers or upper layers, you will see that for the soil tillage, you have more contribution on the upper layers, and for the resident vegetation, the deeper layers contribute with more water for this water consumption. So this is a very important feature by the cover crops. Going on to the effects on vine performance, I use this type of plots with the control as 100%, so meaning that on your left, meaning lower values, on your right, higher values. In this case, there was a slight difference, but non-significant difference either in shoot weight and pruning weight, yield and the yield components, or berry composition. So we didn't notice any effect of this treatment on vine performance. Coming to another experiment near Lisbon, so within the what we call wine growing region of Lisbon, we have a steep slope, slope not too steep, but steep, but a slope vineyard with Cabernet Sauvignon and clay soils. We compared the traditional way they cultivate, so they cultivated the interrow and they use herbicide in the row. So we compared with resident vegetation and sound cover crop. Here I will present only those two treatments, the results from those treatments. So if you take a look to the soil water content, volumetric soil water, the shape, the trend is similar to the one I showed you before. So lower soil water content on the resident vegetation. Again, the daily water use was higher on spring and then no significant difference. And during variation harvest period, we have higher water consumer on the soil tillage. But again, no significant difference in overall periods. Coming to the contribution of each layer, it's about the same. So in this case, we have three layers, and we have higher soil water variation in the upper layer and in the deeper one. And if you take a look to the fraction of this water coming from those layers, again, the deeper layer contributes with more water for this water storage variation. During the period variation harvest, there is no significant difference, but again, the fraction of water that was contributed by the deeper layers was higher in the resident vegetation. Coming to the effects on the vegetative and reproductive components, here we have some different results. We have a strong reduction on the shoot and pruning weight. In this case, we consider it favorable reduction because this was a higher vigor vineyard. No significant difference on yield and yield components, but a positive significant effect on berry color. We attribute this to the indirect effect of the lower vigor in berry microclimate, and so it has increased berry composition. The last case study is in the south of Portugal. We call it Alentejo, so a very hot and dry region, where these problems of water are more complicated. We use the Tempranil, so we call it Aragonese in Portugal. And we compared also soil tillage against resident vegetation. Again, in this case, one difference was that this vineyard is irrigated. So I will show you mainly results before irrigation, because after irrigation, the situation is a little bit more complicated. I will take more time to show that. So, but if you take a look to the volumetric soil water content, you can see also the same trend, not so distinguished like the previous one, but here again, during the period from the spring, we have a difference in soil water content. And again, the same results on daily water use. So higher water use during spring and lower during the other periods. And again, at the end, you have no significant differences. If you take a look to what happens before irrigation during spring, you see exactly the same trend. So higher water use in the by the resident vegetation, either in the upper layers and the deeper layers, and that fraction, the contribution of the deeper layers, in this case from 60 centimeters to 1 meter, is also higher for the resident vegetation. So about the same trend, about the same results from the previous case studies. But regarding the vine performance, here you see that most part of the bars are on your left side, meaning that we got here a reduction on every traits. So a big reduction on vegetative growth, on yield, for the first time we have significant reduction on yield, and a significant reduction on treated table acidity, and no compensation on berry color. So this meaning that we have here unfavorable results. So trying to summarize those results, we can see that Indeed, the cover crop is a very effective tool to manipulate soil water availability. And using the soil tillage as a control, cover crops increase vineyard water use during spring mainly, but showed similar or even lower water use during summer. No significant difference on the accumulated water use. And one important feature is that the soil management practice, in this case cover crops, influence the pattern of water extraction through the monitor profile. So we have the vine root system extract more water from deeper layers. This is very important to recognize that we can use this cultural practice to improve the extraction of water from deeper layers. So regarding vine performance, as I said before, so at down terroir there was no negative effect, so meaning that we can and we should use these cover crops as a cultural practice. In the vigorous vineyard in Lisbon, we had a benefit of using cover crop because it has controlled vigor and enhanced wine quality. However, in this dry condition of Valentage, we have a negative impact on vine vigor. And this negative impact was strong because during winter pruning, the weight per shoot was really low, and we had to improve this vigor because it was really low. And we reduced vigor, but we have any compensation on berry composition. And we also reduce yield, so the grower want not to use this treatment because he has a reduction in yield. However, I have to say that we can mitigate this problem by early irrigating, because in our experiment, we did not begin irrigation earlier. We tried to begin irrigation at the time that the grower wants for soil tillage. And that's why we had more a stronger effect on the resident vegetation. Of course, we can also manage cover crops, like increase the mowing frequency and reduce leaf areas to mitigate this problem. Well, we still have a lot of work to do. It's up to us to try to do more experiments, to try evaluate water use efficiency, test native species, and one very important thing is to better understand this, what we call grapevine root plasticity, in order to better understand how can we use this competition to increase the extraction of water from deeper layers that usually is not used. So that's all. Thank you very much for your attention.